When we think of hospitals, we think about saving lives. Unfortunately, we don't think about the waste that most healthcare establishments produce, from blood to syringes to even to feces disposal, even radioactive wastes. The average patient produces at least 0.5 kilo of waste per day. And the problem is most cities don't have a clean and more economical way of disposing medical waste. So most of these ends up on our landfill, even for first world countries, amazingly. And with the advent of Ebola and all of these viruses that are mutating, this is not good. This is not good. Even the World Health Organization states that 12% of new HIV cases and 40% of hepatitis cases are due to improper handling of infectious medical waste. Incineration. Most countries incinerate their waste, but incineration is dirty, and they're not economical. They're expensive. And most of all, we all know that incinerations, they produce dioxin. And dioxin is one of the most dangerous carcinogens known to man. And yes, dioxins are now found on our milk, on our eggs, even on breast milks. So it's not good. It's not good. So what we did is we developed a system, economical system, to treat medical wastes. And one of the features is to turn plastics into useful gas, which is recycled to the system. So the system is non-incineration. It goes to a thermal chamber where the treatment happens. After the treatment, it goes to a cooling chamber. The output is safe, non-infectious waste, ready for disposal, or carbonized wastes for the carbonization function. So that's two functions, depending on the country. Because for Philippines, we do disinfection because of some regulatory requirements. So currently, we currently operate two facilities in the Philippines, and we have two more on the pipeline by the year. We also have three hospital installations, with seven more installations by the year, before the year ends. So we're gonna have ten hospital installations. We're gonna have four facilities operating by this year. And in 2 years from now, we hope to be all key cities in the Philippines. And by 2022, 2 years from now, we hope to solve the medical waste problem of the whole Philippines. So that's the goal. In 2 years' time, we will do it. So, so we also have plans for expansion. We are now in talks in the Middle East and also in Indonesia, but we're now very focused now on Philippines. And if any one of you wants to help me say goodbye to medical incineration, you can visit me in the Philippines or maybe over beer later. Thank you.